Do you think there's some sort of like different stage of cancer where this is, you know, autophagy becomes more important, like later in cancer when it actually, that's when the metastasis occurs? Or what do you think of that whole field of, you know, autophagy also playing a role in cancer?
I think the autophagy, and I think this was in the paper that was published together with ours by Guido Cromer.
Mm-hmm, Guido Cromer.
And he showed, and Frank Madeo has also been doing work on that, but Guido was showing that autophagy was very, very important during the starvation or using starvation mimicking drugs in causing the exposure of the cancer cells to the immune system, right? So, which probably means that that autophagy is really part of this weakening and maybe death of the cancer cells.
Mm-hmm.
So autophagy turns from something good in a normal cell that it does in a very coordinated way into something bad in a cancer cell, probably because it may break down components that are needed. I mean, I don't know, but,
yeah.
But certainly, you know, autophagy seems to be, you know, at least for this purpose, it seems to be very important, and probably the desperate part of the desperate attempt of cancer cells
mm-hmm.
to get what they need from somewhere, and that's what we see that. In general, we've seen that for almost everything else. Well, I mean, even independently of autophagy, the desperation seemed to be key, meaning that, for example, they tried to increase translation to get more proteins, right? Instead of shutting down like a normal cell would, they go and try to do things that they seem to be desperate. And of course, you can't do that, or you can do it only for so long.
Mm-hmm.
And that's probably why they die.
Yeah. I mean, I know it was something that kind of was confusing to me at first, and then I thought about it for, you know, a little more in depth, and I thought, well, you know, fasting itself is doing so much more than just autophagy as well, so it's not like that's the only mechanism that, you know, it's not that that's a biological mechanism that's changing with fasting, so, but I just thought it was kind of interesting how it seems to be there's sort of this opposite end of the spectrum, you know, effects in terms of cancer.